Alright, one time for my niggas, two times for my noggins. This is Daddy Shiva back at it again with the Melanin Matters Black Light Consciousness or Dark Light Consciousness lecture. Trust me, it's not even going to be too long. I wouldn't even really want to call this a lecture, more just a introduction to future presentations that I'm going to be doing. Because I can clearly see, you know, just by being on Twitter and some of the shit that's been said to me the past couple of days in terms of melanin and white hoteps and all this other crazy shit, I can clearly see that black people actually don't have a good understanding of what makes them God on this planet. They don't actually know what melanin is. They don't actually understand the science behind it. They're just running off pure feelings. And like I said, I've been trying to combat this hyper feminization, right? Niggas have been running on pure feelings, but they have not yet gained a logical left brain understanding of why it is that these feelings might actually be real. They just been running with pure emotion with no logic behind it. So a very feminine stance to take on the subject, and you're gonna get washed out here because your enemy is left brained. You feel me? The quote-unquote white man is a very left-brained organism. You feel me? They love logic. They love science. They do not respect spirit like that. So in order for you to get them to understand spirit or whatever, because I know most of the time when y'all talk about melanin, y'all just trying to prove a point to white people. So why not study the compound itself? Why is it that I can go on Twitter and motherfuckers can tell me that I need to let melanin be great without actually going in depth on melanin and all this extra shit and using these big words? And what kind of psychosis, what kind of mind control are black people under now to where they can be proud of something without actually even knowing what it is? That's crazy. So I want to take the time to really discuss this shit because I actually have a book on the shit and I actually really do study. I really do read. Like, please don't get it confused. Like, I take what I do seriously. Like, I really do. So when I say that there is no such thing as a white hotep ever in your life, please understand, I got the knowledge to prove it. I have the knowledge to prove it. You feel me? I'm going to show you just a couple of notes that I took from this shit. My phone's upside down. I look crazy now. Yo, I'm going to show you a couple of notes that I took from this shit. I didn't even break through the introduction. Mind you, I love this book. This book has shown me so much shit and explained so much shit to me about the spiritual experiences I have, the biochemical things that are going on, all the different layers and components to really integrate all of this knowledge into a holistic view. This book, Dark Light Consciousness, Melanin, Serpent Power, and the Luminous Matrix of Reality by Edward Bruce Bynum. You want to know why there's an Egyptian man on the front of this? Because this nigga Edward Bynum is black. There's a PhD. You see that, right? PhD. He has a college degree, right? From the white man. Since that's all y'all really be respecting anyways. He has a college degree from the white man. And he tells you that the ancestors already figured out all this melanin shit. Okay? So we're gonna take it from this book right here. I didn't even crack through the introduction for these notes. Literally, what I found just in the introduction to talk about in this book, because I was going to go in depth, but I was like, nah, I'll save that. I'll make a course on that. So y'all niggas can actually pay for the knowledge and learn something real in depth. Because most of y'all not going to buy this book. And most of y'all not even going to read it. Even if you do buy it. So anyway, with that being said, I wanted to take a little bit of time to deal with this shit because it really is important. Because niggas actually don't know what melanin is. So we're going to talk about what melanin is. What is melanin? I'm reading this straight off my notes, right? What is melanin? I'm also going to cite the sources so that way y'all can go and check against what the fuck I'm saying, right? Now, melanin is a carbon-dense pigment found in skin, the internal organs, and in much higher concentrations in the central nervous system or the cerebrospinal nervous system. All right. And when it's in the cerebrospinal nervous system, it's neuromelanin. All of the melanin in the nervous system is neuromelanin. Skin melanin comes in two types: pheomelanin, which is what white people have, and eumelanin or true melanin, which is what black people have or people of African descent have. All right? Okay. Keep that in mind. Now, here's the next thing. I'm building a real case for melanin. I'm building up points, you feel me? So just stick with me right now. Melanin's carbon composition and tetrahedrons are triangular pyramids, right? So melanin's carbon composition and tetrahedral triangular pyramid structure makes it a highly conductive amorphous semiconductor and transducer, right? We're going to define that. Mind you, these definitions are not from the book, right? These definitions are not from the book. I went and I researched these terms on my own time. I went on Google and I researched this shit myself. So what's an amorphous semiconductor? An amorphous semiconductor is a solid state material that can be switched from one state to another, right? For example, we could talk about rewritable CDs and DVDs because they switch between an unstructured amorphous state that absorbs light into a structured crystalline state that allows light to pass through, right? So it goes from a state of low resistance to high resistance, or a state of high resistance to low resistance, right? So melanin, as an amorphous superconductor, has an unstructured state that absorbs light and a structured crystalline state that allows light to pass through. You want to know what else is unstructured and absorbs light? That's carbon, coal. You want to know what else gets structured and allows light to pass through? Coal, because it becomes diamond. Listen to what I'm saying to you. Listen to this. So an amorphous semiconductor switches between two states. An unstructured state that absorbs light. Don't black holes absorb light? So when this thing's absorbing light, it's taking light away from your eyes. So it would appear black, right? It's absorbing light. Black absorbs heat, light, energy. So black. It is in a black state. But then when it crystallizes and becomes structured, it allows light to pass through. It becomes clear. Coal, under pressure and heat, over a long period of time, becomes diamond. Why? Because the unstructured carbon atoms in coal begin to get crystallized under the heat and pressure of the Earth's mantle, the core, volcanoes, wherever the fuck you find diamonds at, you feel me? Under all the pressure of the Earth's crust and volcanic activity and all types of shit, right? The molecular structure of that carbon becomes crystallized. Specifically, it becomes crystallized in the geometric shape of the icosahedron, right? Which is the platonic solid that relates to water. All right, remember that. So here we are, we're dealing with this amorphous semiconductor, and we can already see how carbon itself already correlates to this amorphous semiconductive property that melanin has, right? So what we're saying is melanin has the ability to go from an unstructured state that absorbs light, magnetic, to a structured crystalline state that allows light to pass through or gives off light, electric. So melanin is really an electromagnetic force, right? But that's what semiconductors are. They conduct electromagnetic forces. So melanin, as an amorphous semiconductor, can switch between states of high and low resistance, which means that it can either allow lots of energy to pass through, or it cannot allow any energy to pass through and absorb energy. So you can either be in a receptive, introverted state or an extroverted, outgoing state. You feel me? Please keep that in mind. All right. Now we're going to go to the next point, which is, what's a fucking transducer? You need to know what a transducer is and what a semiconductor or an amorphous semiconductor is in order to figure out what melanin is. So a transducer is a device that converts one signal or form of energy into another signal or form of energy. Doesn't an amorphous semiconductor already switch from one state to another? Now we're saying that melanin, as a transducer, switches one form of energy into another form of energy. Let's think about that. Melanin already has an unstructured magnetic state and a structured crystalline electric state. So melanin itself is an electromagnetic particle, right? On top of that, melanin is also able to convert one form of energy into another form of energy. So let's think about that. Melanin absorbs light, correct? From the sun. We know that. That's the science we've all been talking about. Black people are solar beings. We need to be out in the sun. We absorb sunlight. Melanin. All right, cool. So if melanin absorbs sunlight, which is electromagnetic light, it can then convert it into other forms of energy, such as nuclear energy, chemical energy, mechanical energy, you feel me? All sonic energy, all different types of energy melanin can convert the shit to. Now let's think about that in the body. If melanin can take electromagnetic forces, right? Mind you, your heart is magnetic, and your brain is electric, right? If melanin can convert these electromagnetic forces into mechanical energy, then that means that melanin is the reason you can even move your finger. Melanin is the reason you can blink. You feel me? Right? If melanin is converting chemical energy into mechanical energy, then that's why you can eat food and get that shit turned into energy, so that way you can move your body, you can be conscious, you can be awake. Right? So here we go with this particle, this melanin, that not only has two states that it can exist between, it's a fluidic type of molecule because it can switch between these two states very easily, amorphous, unstructured, and then structured, right? On top of that, it can also take electromagnetic energy, chemical energy, nuclear energy, solar energy, all those different types of energy, and convert it into every other type of energy that it wants. So it can make sound out of light. It can make heat out of noise. You see what I'm saying? This is melanin. This is how this shit works. This is just based on pure definitions on what a semiconductor is and what a transducer is. All right? So now in my mind, as I'm looking through this, mind you, that came from just the introduction. That came from me researching just a little tiny bit of information that I got out of the introduction to this book. Not even chapter one, nigga. Just the introduction. Let's continue, though. We're going to talk about what it means for melanin to be an amorphous semiconducting transducer. Right? We're going to talk about that. We got to open that field up now. Mind you, all of that information, aside from the definitions that I just gave you, came from the book Amorphous Semiconductor Switching and Melanin by McGinnis, Proctor, and Corey. Go look that shit up. Go read it. Go read it for yourself. I don't got to argue with you. I don't have to argue with you. Go read that shit for yourself. White people said it. I'm going to sound like white names to me. McGinnis, Proctor, Corey. Yeah, it'll sound like white names to me. Those are Europeans researching this shit and telling you what this shit is. So in summary, melanin as an amorphous semiconductive transducer is not only able to absorb and radiate electromagnetic energy, but it's also able to shift it into other forms of energy such as nuclear, sonic, chemical, mechanical, etc. So what we're really saying here with all this information, mind you, this is just a taste. This is only 12 minutes. I really didn't even go that far. You feel me? And all I did was prove that your black ass melanin can become diamond like or crystalline in nature, which is exactly what niggas like Pharaoh be talking about when they talk about ascension, but they don't even know the whole science behind this shit correctly enough to prove how it's possible. They just say these things out the asshole because they heard someone else say it and they think they know, but they really don't know. You have to be able to talk about it like this, and if you want anyone to believe what the fuck you're talking about, right? This is why you are special, because you melanin has the full range and access to the entire electromagnetic spectrum, which means that it can transmute the entire electromagnetic spectrum into whatever the fuck it wants. Pheomelanin begins to break down when it enters the UV range of light. That means that above the visible light spectrum, white people begin to go crazy. They begin to break down. Their body structure, their biochemical makeup cannot handle anything above UV light. Mind you, if we even look at the visible light spectrum, there are seven colors, right? Okay, let's compare those seven colors to the rest of the electromagnetic spectrum. You got radio wave, microwave, infrared, visible light, UV, X-ray, gamma. Wow, isn't that funny? You have seven colors in the rainbow and also seven different frequencies of electromagnetic light. And white people are capped at number four, visible light, because of UV, their melanin, pheomelanin, begins to break down. Mind you, skin melanin is not the most important. It's not. Even this book could tell you that. Skin melanin is just a surface phenomenon. But that surface phenomenon tells you what kind of melanin your neuromelanin is made up of. It tells you the capacity of your neuromelanin. That's what's important, because your neuromelanin is located where? In your cerebrospinal nervous system. You want to know where that is? Cerebrospinal, your brain and your spine. That's all Kundalini shit. Wow, isn't that ironic? The most heavily melanated parts of your body is where Kundalini is. And I've been talking about all this tantric shit this whole time. This is why I've been talking it, because I understand the science of melanin. You have to understand that in order for you to activate all that shit, you need to have the component in your vehicle that allows you to transmute all those different forms of electromagnetic radiation, because that's what your aura is. 7 layers of electromagnetic radiation, right? You having you melanin have access to the entire electromagnetic spectrum. White people, their melanin begins to break down. Pheomelanin, pheo melanin, pheomelanin begins to break down in the UV range. Once they get into the UV range and above, they start to get cancer. Mind you, our sun is giving off all the spectrums of light, not just visible, all the spectrums of light. This is what I'm saying to you. So if there's 7 colors in a rainbow, and we know those 7 colors in the rainbow relate to the 7 other, to the entire 7 spectrums of electromagnetic light, right? But we also know that those 7 visible colors relate to the 7 chakras, then each one of your chakras relates to a specific frequency of electromagnetic light, right? So if white people, their melanin begins to break down at the UV range, that means that once they start to move above the heart chakra, they cannot do the shit. They are not here. They are not here. White people do not, 85% of white people have deficient melanin. Right? 85% of white people have deficient melanin. 85-90% of white people have pheomelanin. Right? There are some white people out there that have eumelanin. Yeah. Yeah. I know that. But I can't give exceptions because they don't know that. They still think they crackers. You feel me? They don't know that. They're not ready for that yet. It is what it is. But at the end of the day, 85% of them have mutated, inefficient melanin. So they cannot even rise above the heart chakra. Right? And shit probably starts getting a little shaky once they get into the heart chakra. But that lower nature, mind you, the heart chakra is already separated from the lower 3 chakras by the half-step mirror wall called the diaphragm. You feel me? You already gotta crack a whole fucking veil in order to get into the heart. And these niggas are already starting to fucking get deficient when they get around this range and this range. This is why I'm saying white people do not have the same access to a soul that black people have, because they cannot transmute all of the electromagnetic light spectrum, which is what the soul is. The soul is a sun. If you cannot stand out in the real sun, how the fuck do you have a sun inside of you? How do you transmute those electromagnetic forces if your melanin is not able to fully grasp the entire range? Right? You want to know what else is funny? 85% of white people have an inactive pineal gland. So what does that mean? That means that they're not tapping into this X-ray gamma ray frequency that is the pituitary and the pineal. They start breaking down at the throat chakra. They can't even communicate universal truth half the time. And then they're in the heart and shit starts getting shaky in the heart. Mind you, the heart is supposed to be the balancing point of the energetic body. And you're already starting to get a little shaky in that point. This is what I'm saying to you. You have to understand the full science of melanin in order to really comprehend what's going on. You, black man, are under pressure and heat. You are being crystallized into your perfected form. Right now, you're absorbing all these lessons. You're taking in this energy. You're being crystallized. You're heating up. Your Kundalini is rising. You see me? It takes heat and pressure to turn coal into diamond. The pressure is white people. The heat is your Kundalini. Once that shit rises and comes out your third eye, crystallization happens. You become a diamond-like body. Right? Mind you, I just said the icosahedron, which is the molecular structure that carbon has to take up in order to become diamond, is related to the element of water. Mind you, if we go back to the Titan story in the Greek mythology, we know that the gods burned up the Titans, right, took the water from the they but no they burned up the Titans and used the ash from the Titans, that titanium ash, we'll call it, to create humanity. Then they took the water that they got from the Titans after burning them, they turned that into the oceans, and then they threw salt in it so that way the Titans could not regain their power. It sounds like that was a process of separating melanin and water, right? Why is it that black people need all this water? Why is it that all these African cultures venerated water on such a high level? They say we come from a watery abyss, a black watery abyss. You feel me? So diamond has to take up the icosahedron structure. I mean, carbon has to take up the icosahedron structure in order to become diamond. But the icosahedron is related to the element of water. And water and melanin already have a crazy connection, because if you look at the icosahedron, you will see the tetrahedron inside of it. You will see that icosahedron is made up of tetrahedrons. So what am I saying here? Maybe I'm theorizing that with drinking all this water, maybe we are recrystallizing our melanin in a new fashion and form, so that way it can do shit that it didn't do before. Maybe a lot of our problem is that we're dehydrated, right? That's what the Greek myth said. They said they salted all the water in the world, all those oceans we can't drink, right? They salted all the water so that way the Titans couldn't regain their power. Go read the mythology, nigga. Go read the mythology. Right? Even in the Hebrew perspective, we have the feminine element being taken out of the body of man. The water, the feminine element, mind you, your body is 70% water. So why is it that all these things are now connecting on these different levels? Y'all niggas gotta start understanding melanin. I'm telling you, y'all gotta start understanding melanin and really start learning the science. Right now, I'm not even really making a good point. I'm just pointing shit out to prove all these different connections that are going on between this, that, and the third, because you niggas really don't understand melanin, and I really need y'all to go get this book and start understanding melanin. Start understanding these sacred geometric sciences, because alchemy is the study of how to perfect blackness. They knew that we would get into a state where our melanin would become almost completely inactive. Almost completely inactive. This shit is functioning just enough for us to be physically based beings. We have to perfect it. We have to raise that black state melanin into that golden state melanin through the process of alchemy. We have to put ourselves under that pressure to become better. We did that. We created white people as that pressure to perfect our melanin, because we knew that we had already conquered physics. We needed to move beyond physics. That's why we got into metaphysics. That's why we were studying melanin. We were trying to figure out how to fucking get out of here. When we were doing it in Egypt, we needed all these big ass elaborate pyramid structures and all that different shit, because all we were doing was mimicking melanin in the body. We took the pyramidal structure of melanin and we put that shit outside of us and said, yo, we're gonna use this to get ourselves out of here. But in a couple thousand years, this shit's not gonna work. We're gonna need to figure out how to completely internalize the transmutation process. This is why they studied melanin, because they knew that we would be the ones to figure it out. Melanin is the philosopher's stone. It is the one substance that can transmute anything. All you have to do is perfect your transmutation methods. Melanin will handle the rest. Drink water, nigga. You need it. Drink water. You need it. The minute you start studying the sacred geometry associated with melanin and water and all this different, you will see the points that I'm making about drinking water. As soon as you start to understand the chemical and molecular sciences that I was dropping about coal turning into diamond and the spiritual implications of that process in terms of pressure and heat and kundalini and white people, once you understand all of that, you will be a completely different nigga. You will not say stupid shit like white hoteps, because you will understand that 85% of them, the vast majority of them, are nothing like you. Not at all. They cannot make it past the heart chakra. They cannot make it past visible light. They cannot make it past the third dimension. They cannot live beyond three dimensions, because they can't access higher. Well, let me say this. They can't access higher than the astral realm. Let me be fair. Let me not say physical, even though the astral realm is connected to this physical matrix still. So With that being said, if they begin to break down beyond visible light, that means that they cannot exist beyond the visible light spectrum. The visible light spectrum is where we live right now. So there is no ascension for 85% of them. So there is no such thing as a white hotep. That shit's a joke. That shit is a joke. And that's why I laughed at that shit. It's a joke. It has to be funny. Because if we're being serious, then black people are really, really sick and don't understand themselves at all. And are being mind controlled yet again by white people, right? So now that you heard about melanin, you feel me? You just willing to run with whatever. You're not actually willing to study this shit deeper to have the deepest understanding of the science that you can have. No, you're just letting the mass consciousness drive what you know. It's not good enough anymore in 2017, dog. Get you a book. Get you a good, comprehensive book, nigga. Why do you think I always suggest Panic and Bobby Hemmett to you niggas? They always suggest books. Books for you to read. Why do I say read? Why do I say research? You need the logical understanding in order to create a basis for the feelings that you feel. You have to be androgynous with your study. You can't just have all these feelings in your head and just run with all your feelings. You need logical support, or else your ego is never going to fully accept your power. You need to have the logic that explains this shit. And I'm going to keep this video under 30 minutes because I didn't even want to be here too long with this shit. But please understand, I'm not even trying to snap on niggas or nothing like that. I can see that this shit is fucked up. I can see y'all niggas don't understand. So let me show you where I got this shit from. Go learn this shit. Go learn the science of melanin in depth. You need to know words like tyrosine. You need to know words like eumelanin, pheomelanin, neuromelanin. You need to understand this shit. You need to know words like amorphous semiconductor. You need to know words like transducer. You need to know these words. You need to know how the electromagnetic light forces and the also sonic forces, because light and sound create the universe. You need to understand how these forces create the universe and then how they interact with melanin, because melanin is what's shifting everything. Melanin is the regulator in your body. This is the fifth element. Melanin is the fifth element. It's what's changing any of the four elements into any other of the four elements. Do you understand me? Please go study. Please, I'm begging you. You need to know why your blackness is powerful. You cannot keep running around with half-assed understandings talking about you trying to be holistic. That makes absolutely no sense. You need the right and the left brain. You need the feelings and the logic. Androgynous thought is what I'm promoting. I'm an androgynous. Fuck feminism. Fuck all that shit. I'm an androgynous. I support the balanced unification of the male and female forces. Because if you don't have it, you're going to run around in circles. Either that, or you're going to be too fucking headstrong to actually analyze shit in a full circle. Either you're going to be too linear or too curvy with it, or just spinny with it. You need to put a dick on that shit, yo. All this spiritual shit you niggas talking, you need to put a dick on it. You need to put some logic to it. You need to put a phallus on it. You need to put that male principle in it. Stop going with feelings. Start going with feelings and logic. If the logic supports your feelings, good. If the feelings support the logic, good. If they can't meet nowhere in the middle, let that shit go. That's all I'm saying. It needs to be balanced now. So I'm going to keep... I'm showing you the book, Dark Light Consciousness. This shit is like... God knows how many 300-some pages of just everything you could possibly want to know. All types of diagrams with the spine and shit. All types of sacred geometry in here. They talk about the Sri Yantras. They go into all the different mythologies. They really break this shit down on a comprehensive level. So you need to go learn this shit. One time for my niggas. Two times for my nagas. Melanin matters, yo. Melanin matters. And until you understand why melanin matters, don't nothing matter. And ain't nothing gonna change. I'm out.